They're moving on. Yeah, they're giving up. Don't lose your nerves. You're videoing, sir?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that's your bloody not believe it.
The baby is probably in the best position because the wild dogs can't actually leverage themselves on anything to get that low. But it's just a shear. This male, that the wild dogs are pretty close behind this man. If he had kind of flint, he might have put himself in a more precarious position. Unfortunately, they're just outnumbered here, so if you watch them, you have nice perspective because they're like starting with an area where like one sort of bouncing around the rock. So you see that they're very agile on the rock, but I don't think their agility will be a match for a pack of wild dogs this big should they choose to feed.
Right. And they don't have enough
rocks in there. Yeah, I mean, there's two here. I don't know what it looks like behind them, but I know that there are a number of wild dogs that are. There were some that went up in that direction.
Did they split like that?
Yeah. Yeah, they would. And then they do like a long to try and contact call to one another. So everyone in the pack will do that in different areas and that's how they locate one another.
You can cover it like that. Spot the land.
Yeah.
And find two different kills and then go back to them.
Yeah. That was crazy. It was nice to be able to watch from the band and it's like a little bit because of the perspective.
Yeah.
if they can catch that wildebeest, it can be nice, eh? Oh, that wildebeest has seen them. They're all lying flat, but he's seen them now.